What's going on, guys? Corey here. I'm going to put together a video for, this is not something I was asked about. This is something that I see constantly. I see people write about it and I think I'm a member of a couple different groups. I don't spend a lot of time in groups because most of the groups generally is arguing and stuff, and I don't partake in any of that. The question I see a lot, I get asked some, but it's been a while since I've been asked personally, but it's about vinegar. Vinegar and carpet cleaning, vinegar and cleaning in general. People like to add vinegar to their cleaning solutions. This is basically what I'm going to try to explain. It's basically the basics of how pH works and where vinegar comes into play and what vinegar does to your cleaning solution when you add it to it. A lot of people think that it's going to help them get something cleaner if they add vinegar to it. We're gonna go over here. I've got some stuff set up on the counter. I've got vinegar and I've got ammonia, and they represent both sides of the pH scale. The pH scale runs from basically 0 or 1 to 14. 7 is neutral. So anything from 7 to 1 is acidic. Anything from 7 to 14 is alkaline, which alkaline is basic, which means soap. So when you hear alkaline, people basically mean soap. And vinegar and like muriatic acid and oxalic acid, hydrofluoric acid, all of those are on between 7 and 1. So let's take a look here where these things, I'm gonna try to get everything set up. I don't have my wife's not here to help me with this, so I'm gonna try to put this together as well as I can with just a just tripod. So hang on just a second here. All right, it's gonna have to do here. Anyway, this is basically how you test your pH. You can go to Amazon and order these litmus paper for almost nothing. And you can see here, it's got all the different places from 1 to 14. 1 is a extremely powerful acid. 14 is an extremely powerful alkaline. Hopefully we're still seeing this here. And 7 is right in between. And generally, like Dawn soap will come in at about 7. It's neutral. It is possible for neutral cleaners to clean well, and Dawn is an example of that. You can actually successfully clean carpet with Dawn and peroxide. Won't hurt a thing. It can't hurt a thing. It's neutral. Basically, the same way with like Tide and all those other detergents. They're designed for you to wash your clothes with them, week after week after week after week, for years and years and years, and have it not wear your clothes out. Well, when you clean with something like this, clear ammonia. If you were to wash your clothes in clear ammonia, once a week for a period of years, eventually the dye would eventually finally go away, because anytime you add high pH to a dye, it reduces the dye. So that's why it does so well in carpet, because you're trying to take away years and years of soil in one cleaning, and you need something really high pH to do that. Not in every case, but a lot of the ones you'll run into, people wait too long to have their carpet cleaned. To cover some more about this. Ammonia and vinegar, like I said, two different things. Vinegar is used for cleaning basically like water deposits, lime scale, stuff like that, off of your shower or out of your coffee pot. That's what that's good for. Ammonia, being an alkaline, basically a soap, that's used for removing soil and breaking down, things that you want dissolved. One does not do what the other does. And when you mix them together, they will cancel themselves out. So let's take a look here. Let's take a look at ammonia first. We're going to pour that in here. We'll take a look at what the pH is of that. Then we'll take a look what the pH is of vinegar. Just so we don't forget here, because we're only carpet people. We're not that smart. We're just carpet people. And believe me, you don't have to be that smart to be carpet people. You need to know the basics of pH, but that's about it. That's about it. This is not rocket science. All right, now, you're looking at a 14 on the pH scale right here. 14, extremely strong. That's strong stuff. That'll make your skin crack. Put your fingers in there and you don't rinse it off really well, it'll make your skin crack. All right, now over here, this is where I dunked it in the vinegar. And vinegar is coming in at about a, somewhere between a 2 and a 3. Somewhere between a 2 and a 3. So let's do that on a different one here, just to show one more time where we're at, since you don't get to see the regular color of it. Got it blue on one side. All right, now, here we go. Take a look at that again here. All right. Again, you're looking at 2, 3, 4, something like that. So it's acidic, and it says 5% on it. So, you know, they're close. They're close. All of this is close, and a close gets you pretty good here with the carpet cleaning world. Now, what happens? Let's say you want to. I've seen people write and ask about, you know, about putting vinegar in their pre-spray. So what happens when you put vinegar in your pre-spray? All right, now we're going to take a pH of 14, and we're going to take this 5%, and we're going to put that in there. You know, as far as equal parts, you know, they're basically about the same. So let's just put a little of that in there. All right, now we're going to see what happens. What happens to your pre-spray when you add vinegar to your pre-spray? Now keep in mind, it's alkaline that moves soil and carpet. It's alkalinity does that. All right, so what have we got here? We poured a little bit of acid into a little bit of alkaline, and we are coming in at, I want to say about a 10 now. All right, let's see, let's put a little more in there. Now we are coming in at about a 6. So when you add vinegar to your alkaline pre-spray, what you're doing is you're destroying it. You are nullifying it, making it go inert. So if you're adding vinegar for the reason of boosting your pre-spray, you're not doing that at all. The only reason why you would use vinegar in your pre-spray is if you felt like it was too strong and you wanted to weaken it up a little bit. Vinegar will do that for you. Vinegar will also clean your coffee pot really, really well. It'll clean your bathroom really well, but it is not for cleaning carpet. What vinegar will do, if you mistakenly put vinegar on a stain that you're trying to remove, it will permanently lock it in. The acid will lock in a dye. So vinegar and carpet cleaning don't go together, just like end cap and carpet cleaning don't go together. That's a different video entirely though. All right, I believe I got my point across, and I know this will help somebody, and I know that it will irritate somebody, and somebody will love it, somebody will hate it, but that's just it. That's how pH works. Anyway, thanks for watching the show, guys. God bless. See you on the next video.